introduction to Shakespeare's play The Merchant of Venice, Antonio, a prosperous merchant in Venice, worries he has overextended his fortunes in his most recent venture, sending ships to several different ports. Still, Antonio doesn't hesitate to send his beloved friend Bassanio to borrow money from Shylock on Antonio's credit. That way, Bassanio can court the wealthy Portia with whom he's in love. In the Rising action, Shylock is introduced as a Jewish moneylender whose relationship with Antonio has been overwhelmingly negative. Shylock is reluctant to lend him money and only agrees when he comes up with the idea of a merry bond using a pound of Antonio's own flesh as collateral. Meanwhile, Portia has her own problems. She is coping with an abundance of suitors and fears she will be forced to marry one of them because her father, before he died, created a challenge to choose a suitor for her. He set up 3 caskets or boxes, 1 gold, 1 silver, 1 lead, each with riddles on them. The man who chooses the casket with Portia's portrait inside gets her hand. Bassanio selects the correct casket, the lead one, so he can marry Portia. Meanwhile, in Venice, Shylock's daughter Jessica elopes from her overprotective father and marries Lorenzo, a Christian. When she leaves, she takes her father's jewels. Shylock is anguished by the loss of his daughter and riches, especially the ring Jessica's mother gave him before they were married. But he's overjoyed when he learns Antonio's ships have been lost at sea and he can't pay Shylock back. Shylock may be able to exact revenge for Antonio's wrongs by collecting the pound of flesh promised in their contract. Meanwhile, Portia, disguised as a man, heads to Venice to do the right thing, help Antonio. Shylock and Antonio appear before the Duke of Venice for their case to be heard. In the climax of the play, a young lawyer named Balthazar comes to read the contract and save Antonio's life. Balthazar is actually Portia in disguise. She makes an impassioned plea to Shylock to show mercy to Antonio. Shylock refuses, so Portia reads the contract and declares Shylock is entitled to his pound of flesh, but the contract does not allow Shylock to spill any of Antonio's blood. Since it is impossible to take a pound of flesh without spilling blood, Shylock's claim is void. And since Shylock's intention to take a pound of his flesh would have killed Antonio, Shylock is guilty of plotting murder. The Duke spares Shylock's life but takes his fortune, giving half to the state and half to Antonio. Antonio places his share in trust for Jessica and further demands that Shylock convert to Christianity. In the Falling action, as a test of Bassanio's loyalty, Portia asks for the ring she gave him as a reward for her service. Bassanio refuses at first, but Antonio convinces him to change his mind. In the resolution of the play, Portia reveals her disguise and explains her successful plot, and returns Bassanio's ring. The play's happy couples retire to bed as the sun rises.